Now, what are our woodland plants? What are their names?
The pine seedling.
The pine seedling, good. And what was the other one called? Moss, right. We've got two kinds of freshwater plants in our aquarium. Okay, Tiana, what are they called? Do you remember? Great. Those are big words, aren't they? What we're going to do today is we're going to take another look at our plants, and you're going to have an opportunity to add anything else to how the woodland plants are alike. You're going to go over and investigate, use your hand lens. You're also going to look and investigate and observe the freshwater plants and see if there's something else that you can add to this side. Today's lesson, the students were given an opportunity to analyze and make additional observations about plants. We were taking the water plants and we were analyzing how they have similar characteristics of our woodland plants.
I recorded both areas.
Okay, now if you can come up with something, then you can write your observation too, okay?
Both need sunlight. Now,
put it
on the woodland plants.
S. It doesn't have a B in it. S-T-E-M-S. Stems.
Ella, they both have leaves. Right, they both have leaves.
You're looking to see if you see anything different that you want to add that's not already over there for the ways that they are alike. The development of the content area was done very well. The teacher's addition was easy to understand. It was very clear, even toward the end when they were actually doing more of the explanation themselves.
Both are growing. Both need soil. Both are healthy. Both have soil and rocks under them.
Look at your observation skills. This is what you have said. This is what you recorded today. These are your observations that are on blue. You did a great job. And now we are going to compare and see what we can add to the middle section of how both the woodland plants are like the water plants. So they all need food to live. Sydney, you've got an idea? Okay, so they need liquid, water.
Air.
They have to have some kind of air to live.
They both can die.
Okay, they can both die. Okay. Okay, now we've learned a lot about plants, but I have a science surprise because you're going to learn about four amazing plants that I don't think you've heard of. The Venus flytrap. A plant that eats animals.
A plant that eats flies.
If I'm a fly and I come by and I land on it, does it close shut on me the first time?
Nope. No. Second time it'll snap.
Okay, so let's practice. So I want to hear again. What are you going to tell the rest of the group? When we were talking about four amazing plants, we were able to take that lesson on plants and integrate some really interesting pieces on the art that goes along with that, practice on social skills, presenting back, being able to do a little jigsaw activity where they were the experts.
The plant we were talking about was called a rafflesia.
You get to throw your nose because it smells bad.
My students have shown a lot of growth in this unit of study. Some of the students that have been very reserved have come very forward, and they want everybody to know what they know. And so I have been very pleased with that.
Head on it, but not big enough to make you float on it. And